Welcome to my channel, Saren Maitri, your educational mentor. So myself, I'm Saren Maitri, and here in this particular lecture, we'll be studying about how to draw the stick diagram of CMOS inverter. And also we'll try to study how to draw the CMOS layout for the CMOS inverter. So let us first start the diagram of the CMOS inverter with the help of a stick diagram of CMOS inverter here. So we know that CMOS inverter will be having two transistors. One is PMOS, another one is NMOS. This is your Vin input. This is a P1, N1, there's PMOS and NMOS, and this source, drain and source of the transistor. This is a VDD power supply, and this is a ground terminal. And between the drain, we will be supplying our output. For this one, let us draw the stick diagram. So what is stick diagram? Stick diagram is a cartoon of a layout. It means that this particular stick diagram will act as an interface between the circuit diagram and also the layout. So now here, you are supposed to make an interface between the circuit diagram. There's a logical circuit diagram, and also there's a CMOS circuit diagram or logical circuit diagram, and the layout. And what does this interface will do by drawing the stick diagram? It will help us in extracting the digital information in the form of different colors. So now here, the stick diagrams are always been drawn with help of one single line, which are called as a sticks. And there are different layers are there, and these different layers will indicate different patterns of the layout. So let us see now, one after the other. First, in order to draw the stick diagram, we should first draw two power rails. These are the two power rails which will be in blue in color. The power rails will be drawn with the help of metal layer. So this metal layers will be always in blue in color. So upon this one, power rails mark this cross line in order to indicate that a power supply is connected to this one. So we'll mark it as a VDD connection has been made, and here another cross which indicates that ground supply is connected. That's a 0 volts is been connected, or minimum voltage is been connected. Then next, for the PMOS, always you should take the P diffusion. P diffusion layer should be considered. The P diffusion layer will be drawn as a single line, and the color of the P diffusion will be either yellow or brown. So now P diffusion, one P diffusion has been taken here. Upon the P diffusion, you should draw one horizontal line which will be passing between the two terminals. So it means that this will act as a source and this act as a drain, and one perpendicular line has been drawn between this one, and this will act as a gate terminal. So now this entire thing will act as one transistor, that is a PMOS. So since it has been drawn with the help of P diffusion, so it will act as a PMOS. So then next, exactly below this one, draw one N diffusion in the similar stick fashion, and the color of the N diffusion will be in green color, and this one, the top part will act as a drain and this will act as a source. Draw one vertical line between this one, and this vertical line will be drawn with the help of polysilicon. With the help of polysilicon, in short we call it as a poly. The color of the poly will be red in color. So now this acts as an NMOS device. This acts as an NMOS device. You can see that both the gate terminals are connected here. So connect this both polysilicons. The gate terminal has been drawn with the help of polysilicon. So connect both the polysilicon, and you can see that both the drains are connected here. Since both the drains are connected, make the connection between these two drains. But here, you are supposed to use metal layer in order to make the connection. So metal layer has been used. Wherever you make a contact, you'll use two different layers, like polysilicon, P diffusion layer is there, and metal layer has been there. So whenever you make a different kinds of layers to be made as an electrical contact, there you should put one contact. So this indicates a contact. So this is a metal layer. This is a metal layer which is in blue in color. So here also this is of a polysilicon N diffusion. This is of N diffusion and metal layer has been used. So the contact has been done. So again draw one metal layer here. Since this is of metal layer and this is of metal layer, no need of making a contact. Whenever you are using similar kind of layers, or whenever the similar kind of layers are crossing one upon the other, there is no need of any kind of contact. They are electrically contacted already. They are in contact electrically. They are in contact. So now this will act as a output V out. Why? Because here the output is obtained between the two drain terminals. So this is a drain and this is a drain. Output is obtained over here. So now the input of this for the CMOS inverter is given at the gate terminal. So by using one metal layer, draw that metal layer perpendicular to this polysilicon and make a contact here. Why? Because you are supposed to make this polysilicon and metal as an electrode.